So, first of all, I would like to thank the CMAI committee for giving me this great opportunity to delve into the compositions of these great saints, Sri Purandara Dasa and Sri Vadi Raja, and we can really celebrate their legacy through music today. So that I thank CMA committee for this opportunity. I'd like to start out by saying pranams to my parents, to my guru, and to these great saints, Sri Purandara Dasa and Sri Vadi Raja. First, I will be starting with Sri Purandara Dasa. Sri Purandara Dasa was born in the year 1484, and he lived for about 80 years. He was a diamond merchant by trade for most of his life, for the initial part of his life. And at about the age of 30, he underwent a spiritual transformation. He ended up giving away all of his wealth and chose the life of a mendicant, singing the names of the Lord. As a diamond merchant, in those days, he was called Navakoti Narayana. So, you know, back then he had 9 crore rupees. He was so rich that he was also lending money to the king, Krishnadevaraya, at the time. So, you know, if you were to extrapolate that money to today, he would be one of the richest people on the planet, one of the billionaires. So he gave away all of that, and he chose that life where he went from house to house singing the name of the Lord. One of his greatest contributions was the fact that he sang in the local language of Kannada and spread the message of the Upanishads, the highest truths, to the common man through simple language. So, Sri Purandara Dasa is also known as the Pitamaha of Carnatic music. So let us look at some facts about his contribution towards music. He has formulated the initial exercises, such as the Swaravali exercises, the Alankaras, the Geetams that are sung by the beginning students. He also chose the Raga Maya Malav Goda to be used for initial training by students in Carnatic music. Imagine he did that 500 years ago, and still students are still following that. The teachers are still using that format to teach the students. So that itself speaks for the greatness of his vision in coming up with these exercises. And I will add to that, these exercises are not only good for the basic level for students, but also throughout the life of a musician, these exercises can be used to improve the skills. For example, I'll show you. If I take, for example, one of the exercises, Janti Varse, I'll sing it in Akara, just to give you an example of how these exercises can be used for advanced level training also. Example of how we can use these exercises for advanced level training as well. When we sing these in Akara, we can improve our voice culture. We can sing these in different speeds We can also choose different ragas to practice these exercises. Another aspect is, if we look at the saptatala alankaras, these can be used with variations for the advanced students to prepare for the singing of ragam tanam pallavis. Not going to get into any detail there, but just to let you know, in many ways these exercises can be used throughout the life of a musician to increase the quality of their music. So, a little bit more about, you know, his contribution towards music. You can tell the greatness of a person by the influence they had on others. So, if you look back, Sri Rangaramanuja Iyengar says in the history of South Indian music, he says that even the great Venkatamakhi, who formulated the 72 Melakartha Ragas, was influenced by the Sangeeta Shastra, or the musicology, of Sri Purandara Dasa. Sri Tyagaraja lived about 250 years after Purandara Dasa, and when he was growing up, his mother would sing the songs of Purandara Dasa to him. He also pays his respect to Sri Purandara Dasa in the Prahlada Bhakti Vijaya. Towards the beginning, he says, "I ponder in my mind on the greatness of Purandara Dasa, who shines in a state of ecstasy, singing the virtues of Lord Hari, which transforms all bad fates." So that is Sri Tyagaraja's paying respects to Purandara Dasa. I'd like to bring your attention to a particular kind of composition that was created by Sri Purandara Dasa. This is true of other Haridasas as well. He created what is called the Suladi. It's a type of composition where he would sing in different ragas, and also each verse would be in a different meter. So if you can imagine, you know, those of you that have learned the basic exercises, you know how difficult it is to sing Dhruva Tala, Matya Tala, you know, all those talas by themselves, how difficult it is. But if you imagine each verse is in a different tala, you will get some conception of his musical genius to be able to come up with such a composition. Actually, those compositions have not been able to be satisfactorily presented on stage as of now. They are very challenging. If you imagine Purandara Dasa going around house to house without the help of any mridangam or anything, just putting tala with his hands, singing such complex compositions, that gives you an idea. His output was also tremendous in terms of the number of compositions. So it is said that he composed 475,000 compositions during his lifetime. If you think about it, most of those would have been in the latter half of his life, after he became Purandara Dasa. And if you average it out, that's almost 40 compositions a day. So if you just think about that, that is just mind-boggling in terms of, if you think of the depth and the quality of those compositions, it's almost as if whatever he said as he spoke, those truths were just coming forth from his mouth. So, you know, that gives you an idea of his contribution. I will be presenting first a composition, Gajavadana Beduve, in the Raga Hamsadvani. In this composition, Sri Purandara Dasa says, "O Ganesha, you are the son of Gauri. You are worshipped in all the three worlds, and you are the protector of good people. You hold the noose and the goad as weapons, and the mouse is your means of transport, and you are affectionate towards the sages." He says, "Kindly show me your feet so that I may worship, and please give me the power to worship Lord Sri Purandara Vithala." So here you can see that he respects Ganesha, and in other compositions you will also see he respects Shiva and other gods as well. But you can see that his goal is always to worship Purandara Vittala. His focus is always on Purandara Vittala, but he always shows respect to the other deities as well. This composition is in the raga Hamsadhwani. So Hamsadhwani, the scale is sa ri ga pa ni sa sa ni pa ga ri sa. So this raga is an audava raga. So audava is standing for pentatonic. It is a pentatonic in the ascent as well as the descent. The swarasthanas in this raga are Shajja, Chatushruti Rishabha or Ritu, Antara Gandhara, Gatri, Panchama, Kakali Nishada, Nitri. So these same notes are used in the descent as well. This raga was discovered by Sri Ramaswami Dikshitar, the father of Sri Muthuswami Dikshitar, and has been later adopted into the Hindustani system as well. In terms of some characteristic phrases in the raga, just an example, you will see phrases that skip the shajja. So examples of some characteristic phrases in the raga. So I will present the composition and then I will do kalpana swaras. This composition starts after two aksharas. So gacha vadana betu be gabagari sari gacha vadana. That's an example of how I would do kalpana swara there. As I do the kalpana swaras, I want to point out one of the patterns that I will be using. It is a total of 13 aksharas. So it's nisariga, nisariga, nisariga. So just an example I'll show you. The point, you'll get an idea of where this is. Ga ba ga ga di di ga ga di di sa ni sa sa ni sa ri ga ni sa ri ga ni sa ri ga ga pa ni pa ga pa ni ni pa ga ga ri sa ni sa ri ga ni sa ri ga ni sa ri ga. So that's one of the patterns I will use. The korvai that I have chosen will be 32 aksharas times 3. So in these 32 times 3, the first set of 32 will be 15 plus 17. So how do I do 15 plus 17? I will do 3 sets of 5. And then the second set will be 3 sets of 5, but a gap of 1 between those to give 17. That's the first set of 32. The second set, I will decrease in the first half. So I will do 12. To do 12, I will do 3 fours. And then I will do 20. To get to 20, it will be 3 times 6 plus 2 in the same kind of way that I did 5 plus 2 to get to 17. The third set of 32, I will decrease again in the first half. I will do 9, so 3 times 3. And then I'll do 23 in the second part. So that will be 3 times 7 with this gap of 1 between the sevens. So I'll begin with a sloka on Sri Purandara Dasa.
मन्मनोभीष्टदातारं सर्वाभीष्टफलप्रदम् Manmano Bhishta Dataram Sarva Bhishta Pala Pradam Purandara Gurum Vande Gajavadana Beduve Thank you. Gari bagani basani gari sani ba, gari gari. nidariga ganiba ganiba gaba gaba ni nidariga 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 ganiba ganiba ga ganiba ganiga gaba ni ganiba magari ganiga ni gaba ni ni ganiba ganiga ganiga nidari nidari nidariga ganiri 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 nidariga magari ganiba nidariga nidani pasani pa magari ganiga ganiri ganiga magari ganiga gaba ganiri 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 ganiga ganiri ganiga ganiga ganiri ganiri
The next composition I will present is Innu Daya Bharade. This is in the Raga Kalyana Vasanta. Sri Purandar Dasa says in this song, he says, "Do you still not have any mercy on me, on your servant?" He says, "I have taken birth in different times, in different places, in different wombs, and I have fallen into this hell called me and mine, and while being in this, I'm calling out to you as my only refuge. Will you still not have any mercy on your servant?" Then he says, "All the karma that is coming about through my thoughts, words, and deeds, I offer all of that on to you. No matter what I do, my life itself is yours." So he says, "Will you still not have any mercy on this servant of yours?" The Raga Kalyana Vasanta. It's a journey of Kiravani, the 21st Melakarta. It is categorized as the Audava Sampurna Raga. In the ascent, pentatonic. And in the descent, it has all seven notes. The scale is Sa Ga Ma Da Ni Sa Sa Ni Da Pa Ma Ga Ni Sa. The swarasthanas are Shatja. In the ascent, Sadharana Gandhara, Shuddha Madhyama, Shuddha Daivata, Kakali Nishada. And in the descent, there is the addition of Panchama and Chatushruti Rishabha to create the seven notes.
Nana kala kala le na
Next, I will be presenting a composition of Sri Vadiraja Tirtha. Sri Vadiraja Tirtha was a Dvaita philosopher, a poet, and a mystic. He authored many works on Madhva theology as well as metaphysics. He contributed greatly to Dasa Sahitya, writing many poems under the signature of Hayavadana. he lived from 1480 to 1600, so a total of 120 years. I want to talk about the significance of that word Hayavadana. So he worshipped a form of Vishnu that in the form of a horse, and as he worshipped the murti, after the worship he would take the prasad and hold it above his head, and Vishnu would come in the form of a white horse.